and seized its assets. She was dragged through the courts for 10 years.
Based system, which creates scarcity. But it puts a group of insiders in a position of having access to all the data about the economy.
You might say, for the partnership. Now, in return, what do the bankers do for the politicians? They promise to create money out of nothing, now that they've got this legal power to do it, anytime the government needs it.
And since 2008, we've witnessed the greatest fake money printing run in recorded history. This financial sleight of hand disguises the costs, hides who's to blame, and leaves us as debt slaves working to pay off the bill. I found it revealing that in the same year the Federal Reserve was founded, 1913.
You look up for Federal Reserve in the blue government pages, it's not there. It's in the white pages right next to Federal Express. It's a privately owned central bank.
What is the proper relationship? What should be the proper relationship between a chairman of the Fed and a president of the United States?
Well, first of all, the Federal Reserve is an independent agency, and that means basically that there is no other agency of government which can overrule actions that we take. There is no other agency of government which can overrule actions that we take.
We have a private bank that prints money on behalf of the Treasury. The Federal Reserve prints money on a debt-based system which creates scarcity. But it puts a group of insiders in a position of having access to all the data about the economy when we don't. So you have a small group of bankers who understand the data on how the money works in the economy, and it gives them the ability to print money in a way that the insiders are protected and everybody else is drained.
Catherine went on to compare a healthy economy to a vibrant torus, balanced, freely flowing, and energized throughout, in contrast to what's happening in our current economy.
What you have is a system that's very dynamic, and it's trying to optimize. But intertwined in the core of it, you have a tapeworm. The way a tapeworm works in your body is it injects a chemical into your body that makes you crave what's good for the tapeworm and bad for you. You have a parasite that's very much manipulating and engorging itself at the expense of the whole.
We live in a tapeworm economy where the financial elite are the tapeworm and they're feeding on us. And they don't like it when people blow their cover. After Catherine began exposing government corruption at the highest levels, the FBI raided her company and seized its assets. She was dragged through the courts for 10 years before being found innocent. So we've got the Federal Reserve, a privately owned corporation with a monopoly on creating money, but with no accountability, backed up by a government with a monopoly on force. The country got sold on the Fed as an institution that would help stabilize the economy and remain independent of politics. But in fact, in close to a century of existence, the Federal Reserve has done just the opposite. Since they took charge, we've been robbed through inflation, and the purchasing power of the dollar has declined more than 96%.